Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about tibial bowing imaging. Terminology: tibial bowing is typically unilateral, congenital or anti-diaphyseal deformity characterized by direction of upper posterior media. Physiologic bowing frequently secondary to intrauterine positioning. Anteromedia associated with fibula hemimelia. Anterolateral associated with neurofibromatosis type 1. Most common sign symptoms: posterior media tibial bowing present at birth, plus minus associated calcaneal vulgus, leg length discrepancy. Anterior medial tibial bowing present at birth associated with fibula hemimelia. Symptom and presentation depend upon degree of fibula absent and associated anomaly. Anterolateral tibial bowing associated with NS1 tibial bowing typically present in first years of life, may go on to fracture with pseudoarthrosis formation. Etiology: posterior major bowing typical due to intrauterine positioning. Anterior major bowing from fibula hemimelia, unknown etiology. Fibula hemimelia, broad term for postaxial hypoplasia due to disruption of normal low limb wood development. Anterolateral tibial bowing fracture and pseudoarthrosis are due to osseous dysplasia and abnormal cellular healing associated with NS1 mutation. Imaging: frontal and lateral leg radiograph are necessary to characterize effect of deformity. If tibial bowing is present, evaluate for cortical sinking or sinking, fracture or pseudoarthrosis, underlying lesion or abnormal mineralization, fibula hemimelia, associated knee, ankle, and foot deformity. Standing leg length and radiograph characterize limb length discrepancy. Additional radiograph to evaluate for associated anomaly. Foot radiograph, posterior major bowing, calcaneal vulgus, anterior major bowing with fibula hemimelia absent, ray talip, acino vulgus, tarsal collision. Advanced imaging may be used to evaluate associated condition affecting management. Knee in fibula hemimelia may show congenital ligamentous and meniscal abnormality. This is frontal and lateral in the first years of. So, right tibia bowing and shortening of the right tibia and fibula with limb length discrepancy. Posterior tibia bowing and suggested of a foot deformity. Though which bearing you are required to adequately assess disorder of foot alignment. This is a frontal and lateral radiograph in an 8-month-old with fibula hemimelia. So anterior major tibial bowing associated with absence of fibula. AP radiograph in a 6-year-old girl with neurofibromatosis type 1. So lateral bowing of tibia Additional near incomplete fracture line is present in the major aspect of the mid to the distal left tibial diaphysis. In the same patient, confirm bilateral anterior lateral bowing, which characterized of gastric of -1. The fracture is due to associated osseous dysplasia and may go on to form pseudomatosis because of animal cellular healing in -1. And this is the AP and lateral radiograph of the lower leg in a 1 year old with NS1, so anterior lateral tibial bowing with associated cortical thickening, no fracture or pseudomatosis is present in this time. Thank you.